only a small percentage of people that watch our videos are actually subscribed, so if you end up liking this video, please consider subscribing. It's free and you can always change your mind later. Thanks and enjoy the video. So you got yourself one of the best LPVOs money can buy, but now you've got another rifle and need another scope, but this time you want to stretch your dollars, so you're looking for a budget scope. And just to be clear, when we're talking budget, we're really talking about around $500. And I know what you're thinking. How can this be so cheap? Well, you know why.
Bing, bing, bong, bong, bing, bing, bing.
But seriously, this isn't the first time we've looked at budget scopes. The question is, how much value can you really get without cutting too many corners? Well, I'm here to tell you that after spending some time with this new Swamp Fox Arrowhead 1-8, you're going to be really happy with the value and feature set that it brings to the market. Let's take a look at some of the reasons why. Let's go. So for any type of tactical shooting, one of the first questions you should ask for any LPVO is the reticle daylight bright? The answer for this one is, kinda. At its highest brightness setting, it turns a bright red shade that provides just enough contrast between the reticle and the target, but only when you're under cloud cover or dusk lighting conditions. But if it's a clear sunny day, the illumination will not be bright enough to separate the target from the reticle with either its color or intensity. So when the illuminated reticle is on a black target and the background is a little black as well, it might be a little difficult to see the center of the reticle. Reminds me of the primary arms in regard to its intensity and color. However, even without illumination, I like that the black reticle design at 1x is definitely still usable since it's thick enough to stand out from the background. And since it's a donut design, you can easily bracket targets with its 12 MOA circle and the crosshairs that line its ring. Speaking of that reticle, it sits on some of the clearest glass you'll find on any budget scope. Whether you're looking at the center of the scope or its edges, I think it's fair to say that we can assume that we'll have more than good enough glass for any other budget scopes from this point forward. If we compare the Swamp Fox to the earlier primary arms or Attaball scopes, it's really hard to distinguish them side by side in regard to glass quality. However, you can find one distinguishing feature in the Swamp Fox, and that is the field of view, which measures at 122 feet at 1x. Spec-wise, that is a big number when you compare it to the closest primary arms at 110 feet. This doesn't mean that the view is as flat as something like the more expensive Razor, but when you mount the scope at 1x, you'll definitely notice that you have a lot more headroom without any scope shadow. Considering the Swamp Fox's price point, I think this is a big accomplishment. Now that we've taken a look at the internals, let's back out and talk externals. Its 30mm body comes in at 20 ounces in a 10-inch scope tube. This makes it about 3 ounces heavier than the primary arms 1-8. So to cut down on some more weight, we typically mount our scopes in aero lightweights, but for this video we use the worn 30mm skeleton scope mount since it has excellent QD and weighs only 3 ounces more than the aeros. Starting at the rear scope, let's look at the zoom lever. One super nice addition is the included throw lever, which not only adds to the overall value, but its design is quite good and then it sits flush in these grooves. You'll definitely want to use the throw lever though, as the tension to turn the zoom ring is a little stiff, although not as stiff as something like a Vortex PST 1-6. When it comes to zeroing, the scope does not have capped turrets. Instead, this scope has a modified exposed turret design. Modified meaning that you must pull up on the turret to unlock it before you can turn it. Once unlocked, the adjustments are a little coarse at 0.5 MOA per click, so it's about the same as the primary arms 1-8. You push down the turrets to lock them down again, and once locked, you won't be able to move them, although just touching them, you do notice there is a little bit of play in them. Overall, I think it's a very good design, although I generally prefer a lower profile cap design since it keeps the scope body as sleek as possible. On the left side, you will find a large brightness knob that allows you to adjust through the 12 positions of brightness with an off position in between, which is great. Feel-wise though, it's pretty stiff. Just know that when you're turning the brightness knob to change levels, it's going to take a little bit more force than you're used to with other scopes. Now that we've taken a look at the scope internals and externals, let's put some rounds downrange and put this scope through its paces. Targets seen in this video were brought to us by Targets USA, which offers competitively priced and uniquely designed AR-500 steel targets like these Double Up. check out their wide selection from the link listed below. And now back to the video. Our first two stages have IPSC steel from 7 to 25 yards with a mix of close and wide transition targets where scope illumination and field of view come into play. Now that we've seen how scope does a short range, let's take a look at the reticle for long range. You've got three choices when it comes to Arrowhead reticles: BDC, MOA, and mil. If you want consistent and precise hash marks, go with the MOA or mil reticles, whichever measurement you're accustomed to. I like quick shooting, so a BDC reticle like this one serves just fine. With the drops calibrated for XM193 going 3100, you can see that the holes are super easy to remember going out to 800 yards. But since we're using this excellent 13-inch Criterion barrel, so the holds are a little bit different, but still not too bad to remember. The long range stage has IPSC silhouette targets from 200 yards to 500 yards, spaced approximately 100 yards apart. Shooter will have 30 seconds to hit as many targets as possible, starting from near to far and cycling through again in that order. All hits and misses are shown. Max will serve as control shooter for this long range stage, so let's go.
400. Hit 500. Hit 2. Hit 3. Hit 4. Hit 5. Hit
time.
If you're interested in any of the gear featured in this video, the links can be found below in the description. These links help support the channel as well. Thanks, and here are the final thoughts on our featured product. So, in summary, I think we can all see where the trend lines are pointing when it comes to budget LPVOs, and the Swamp Fox serves as a perfect example. Swamp Fox has really delivered as far as clear glass with a usable and well-thought-out reticle, tactile turrets, adjustable illumination, and a large zoom range. Really, its only weakness is its illumination, so if you want something with daylight bright illumination, I'd say you can step it up to the Vortex PST Gen 2. However, given its feature set and aggressive price point, I'd really tell anyone that's looking for a budget LPVO that the Swamp Fox Arrowhead 1 8 will be the scope to be.